I'm Anthony F. Elmore, President and Founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association. Today, we bring you another one of our Proud Black Buddhist lectures. My lecture today is True Buddhism is Education and Not Meditation. In our world today, we think of Buddhism as some Asian on a mountain meditating. Now, in regards to Buddhism and meditation, it is Black America who lacks the true Buddhist education because Asians and whites got Black people doing meditation instead of education. You see, a group of people left Africa thousands of years ago. They were called Cushites. The Cushites inhabited an area that was known during the Afro-Greek writer by the name of Homer as Eastern Ethiopia. The Cushites set up one of the most sophisticated cultures of ancient history that's known in our world today. In fact, look up the word Sarasvati River. The Sarasvati River civilization made a city that was so sophisticated and complex that 2,000 years before people known as white people would ever do city planning and set up a city, these Black Cushite people set up a civilization called the Indus Valley Civilization that was twice as large as Egypt and Mesopotamia put together. From this civilization came an empire called the Magadha Empire. The Magadha Empire was started by a Black people or by a Black man by the name of Sisu Naga. The Nagas were the people who were the Buddhists. Naga means snake or serpent, and Naga represents wisdom. When you look at the Egyptians and you see the snake, that snake represents that the ancient Buddhists were Nagas. They were the Egyptians were Nagas, and they were the people of the Indus Valley Civilization, as well as they were the people who came from the Nile River Valley Civilization, and they migrated all over the world. In fact, in Japan, they were called the Ainu. The Cushites migrated all over the world. Now, the word Buddha means awaken. Buddha also means enlightenment or wisdom. Now, do we relate wisdom to meditation, or do we relate wisdom to education? How do we become a Buddha or to become awakened? You see, do we employ the Asian concept of meditation, or do we employ the Buddha's highest teachings and employ education? See, the Buddha Shakyamuni, during the last 8 years of his life, admonish his followers to employ not meditation, but we should employ as our Buddhist practice education. We who are members of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association practice the Buddhist teachings as taught by the 13th century Black Japanese Buddhist sage Nichiren Shonin, who teaches us that the highest teachings of the Buddha Shakyamuni was the Lotus Sutra. And the way that the Buddha teach us the Lotus Sutra is that we should recite the Lotus Sutra, we should hear the Lotus Sutra, and not necessarily to meditate on the Lotus Sutra. Now, Nichiren Shonin taught his disciples by means of writings or letters that he sent to disciples. They are called the Gosho. And it is the Gosho that teaches us that Buddhism is not meditation, but Buddhism is education. Now, in the Gosho is called the real aspect of the Gohanza. Now, the real aspect of the Gohanza explains how we can attain enlightenment. Now, the basis of the Buddhist practice is education and not meditation. Now, this is what the Gosho reads. Now, this again is the real aspect of the Gohanza. The Gohanza is the object of worship here behind this altar where we chant the sacred words, Namu Myoho Renge Kyo. Now, in this Gosho reads, quote, the first volume of Concentration and Insight says, quote, how do we hear, believe in, and practice the perfect teachings to attain perfect enlightenment, unquote. It goes on further. The first volume on Concentration and Insight says, quote, to believe in the perfect teachings means to awaken faith through doctrine and to make faith the basis of practice. You see, ladies and gentlemen, the way that we who learn Buddhism, we awaken our Buddhist faith through understanding or through studying the perfect doctrines of the Buddhist teachings. You see, the first thing this passage says is, how does one hear, believe in, and practice the perfect teachings? If we are going to believe in Buddhist teachings, we must awaken faith through doctrine and make faith the basis of our practice. See, the basis of the Buddhist practice is to awaken faith. See, we cannot awaken our Buddhist faith through meditation. We awaken our Buddhist faith through education. See, the sutra teach us to awaken faith through doctrine. See, the only way that we can learn and understand the doctrines of Buddhism is through education, not meditation. If you're going to study life and the universe, see, Buddhism is the religion where God and science meets. And it is the Buddhist teachings, or the highest teachings of the Buddha, is the Lotus Sutra, where the Lotus Sutra teaches us the universal concept and all the laws of the universe. You see, for the sake of education, listen to this very carefully. The largest written religious works in the history of mankind is the Buddhist works called the Pali Canon. The Pali language is the black language that was in India. It is the language of the people in India. And in 29 BC, they had the fourth Buddhist Council in Sri Lanka, which was then known as Ceylon, and they wrote the Buddhist teachings down, and these teachings were called the Pali Canon, which is the largest religious works in the history of mankind. In fact, if you took the teachings of Judaism, the Torah, the teachings of Christianity, the Bible, and the teachings of Islam, the Quran, and you put them all together, the Buddhist teachings is four times as large as all of these teachings put together. Furthermore, it was British historian Sir Godfrey Higgins who writes that all of the Western mysticism and all of the teachings of Islam, of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam come from the Buddhist teachings. Now, from the standpoint of Buddhist teachings, meditation is only one of the four guidelines of the practice and way of understanding the Buddhist teachings. You see, the Gosho, now it's titled The Doctrine of the 3,000 Rings, and it reads, quote, the great teacher Tenta was a reincarnation of the Bodhisattva Medicine King. And in his commentaries, he discussed the merits of reciting the sutra and those of meditation. To begin with, in his commentaries, he defined four guidelines for interpreting the words and phrases of the Lotus Sutra. Namely, number one, causes and conditions, correlated teachings, theoretical and essential teachings, and observation of the mind. But persons who do not understand the importance of these four types of interpretation are likely to apply one type of interpretation, turning all of their attention to the way in which the passage relates to the theoretical and essential teachings, or turning all of their attention to how it relates to observation of the mind, unquote. You see, the Gosho, the doctrine of the 3,000 realms, further reads, quote, those who seek to attain Buddhahood solely through the contemplation of the mind are following a one-sided approach. And how much truer is this of those who practice the Zen style of seated meditation and speak of a separate transmission outside of the sutras, unquote. Now it goes on further. In the teacher of the law chapter of the Lotus Sutra, the Buddha states, quote, Medicine King, though there may be persons, those still living in the household, and those who have left it, who practice the way of the Bodhisattva, if they are not willing to see, hear, read, recite, copy, embrace, and offer alms to the Lotus Sutra, then you should know that such persons are not yet practicing the Bodhisattva way in a fitting manner. He goes on further, but if there are those who will listen to this sutra, they are capable of practicing the Bodhisattva way in a fitting manner, unquote. You see, what is the lesson or the education that we proud Black Buddhists World Association share with you? It says, but if there are those who will listen to this sutra, then they are capable of practicing the Bodhisattva way in a fitting manner. The point that you must understand is the proper Buddhist practice is to listen to the Lotus Sutra. We must use our mouth or sutra. We must speak. We must talk. We must share. That is the proper way of Buddhism. It's not sitting and practicing meditation. Now, the Gosho, it's called the Sacred Teachings of the Buddha's Lifetime, reads, quote, with regard to the word kyo, profound meaning says, quote, the voice carries out the work of the Buddha, and this is called kyo, or sutra. You see, ladies and gentlemen, the sutra or kyo, that's the voice of the Buddha. And when we tell people about Buddhism, when we teach Buddhism, when we use our voice and tell people about the Buddhist teachings, this is sutra, this is kyo. When people listen, they can awaken, but we must tell them about the Buddhist teachings. You see, in the Gosho, the true entity of life, it says, exert yourself in the two ways of practice and study. Without practice and study, there can be no Buddhism. You must not only persevere yourself, but you must teach others to the best of your ability, even if it's only a single sentence or phrase. We who teach Buddhism, or we who practice Buddhism, must use our voice to teach Buddhism. We must sing the Buddhist songs. We must send emails and pictures and texts and teach copy, recite. It is so easy to do it now than it did years ago. We can take our cell phone and send a passage. We can recite, we can copy, we can hear, we can listen. We can teach Buddhism. It is not in meditation, but it is listening and preaching and talking the Lotus Sutra. How we can teach Buddhism. You see, the essence of the Buddhist teachings is not meditation. The essence of the Buddhist teachings is education, or what we call cho. You see, the Gosho, the Dhammoku of the Lotus Sutra reads, quote, within the single character cho are contained all the sutras and the worlds throughout the 10 directions. It is like a wish-granting jewel that contains within it all manners of treasures of the vastness of space that encompasses all phenomena. And because this single character kyo of Myoho Renge Kyo is the supreme achievement of the Buddha's lifetime of teachings, the other four characters, Myoho Renge Kyo, likewise surpass all other 80,000 doctrines the Buddha taught. Unquote. You see, the word kyo encompasses all phenomena. In common sense terms, when we say kyo, we are speaking of not only the Buddhist teachings. This concept is inclusive of all the teachings in the universe. In a general sense, meditation is a part of kyo, but the essence of kyo is learning the Buddhist teachings or education. In a specific sense, Buddhist education means to awaken. To awaken means to grasp wisdom. You see, the Gosho, entity of the mystic law, reads, quote, the supreme principle, that is, the mystic law, was originally without a name. When the sage was observing the principle and assigning names to all things, he perceived that there is this wonderful single law, Myoho, and that simultaneously possesses both cause and effect, Renge, and he named it Myoho Renge Kyo. This single law, that is, Myoho Renge Kyo, encompasses within it all phenomena comprising the 10 worlds and the 3,000 realms and lacking in none of them. Anyone who practices this law will attain both the cause and effect of Buddhahood simultaneously. Now, it goes on further. The sage practiced with this law as his teacher, and he attained enlightenment, and therefore he simultaneously obtained both the mystic cause and the mystic effect of Buddhahood, becoming the thus come one of perfect enlightenment and fully realized virtues, unquote. You see, the Buddhist teachings are where God and science meets. See, the Gosho is called the doctrines of the 3,000 realms. It says, quote, if there are those who hear the law, then not one will fail to attain Buddhahood. Here it speaks of those who hear the law, but if it were referring to those who attain Buddhahood through meditation, it would say, if there are those who meditate on the law. You see, we must hear the law. We as proud Black Buddhists must teach the law to our people. When we look at Dr. Martin Luther King or Malcolm X, Raheem Mbeki or Nelson Mandela, they use their voice to teach. Now, while the teachings of the Buddha is the highest teaching in the universe, Asians got Black people not only doing the dumbest Buddhist practice in the world, you got some white people who purposely promote delusion. See, let me be clear. White supremacy is a delusion in the history of mankind. There never existed any white people who conquered Black people in ancient India called Aryans. There were never a group of white people called Aryans. It never existed. When the light-skinned Brahmin language Sanskrit was being invented, they took the word Arya from the Black language of Prasakit, and they invented the word Aryan. They created a false writings called the Vedas or myths, and they came up with a theory called the Aryan invasion theory, whereas these so-called super white people came in and conquered the Black people. They were called Aryans. no such thing has ever happened. Yet, the Japanese and the Asians who teach us Buddhism, they teach about the Aryan invasion theory. It never happened. That is not the true teaching. See, the word yo means correct. It is not the true teaching. See, the Buddha intoned. The Buddha was the first to intone Myoho Renge Kyo. The word myo means correct. It means mystic. It means incomprehensible. It means wonderful. He explained that all life is myo, and when life manifests, it's called ho or lo. Now, the Buddha used the symbol of the lotus to explain the simultaneousness of the law of cause and effect. Now, the teachings or the essence of this law is called Kyo. And how do you get the Kyo out? The Kyo, or the workings of the Buddha, or the teachings of the Buddha, the Kyo is what we have. Our voice explains the Kyo. Our voice explains the sutra. We are to teach Buddhism. You see, again, the sacred teaching of the Buddha lifetime reads, with regard to the word Kyo, profound meaning says, quote, the voice carries out the work of the Buddha, and this is called Kyo Sutra. See, the voice is called Kyo. Kyo is education, not meditation. Anyway, let me bring this lesson to a close. The voice carries out the work of the Buddha. All of the great black leaders use their voice to make change in the world, or to do good, or to do the Buddha's work. They all had one thing in common: education of their humanity, of their God-given birthright. Dr. Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Nelson Mandela, Dr. Henry Abeka of India, they had in common was a correct understanding of history and a lot of faith and a lot of Kyo, a voice. They use their voice to spread the truth. And that's what we do. That is what Buddhism is about. We teach our history. We teach our culture. We teach our language. You see, we chant the words, Namu Myoho Renge Kyo. Namu means to awaken. How do you awaken? You awaken the Gosho, the real aspect of the Gohanzon, reads, how does one hear, believe in, and practice the perfect teachings to attain perfect enlightenment? The first part of concentration insight says, to believe in the perfect teaching means to awaken faith through doctrine and to make faith the basis of our practice. We study the doctrines of Buddhism, and when we understand these true and perfect teachings, we gain faith. Anyway, let me bring this to a conclusion. The word Namo means to say, wake up! Wake up! Wake up!
Thank you.
I told the girl about my decision to join the Buddhist religion. She says, how could you leave the church? Don't you believe in God? I told her that it's not about God, it's about us. Oh, they like the tin man, scooping on down the Oz. Trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself hard. Oh, they like the tin man, scooping on down the Oz. Trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself hard. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I find those who say there's no heaven in God, they're no more than a wizard of Oz. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a heart. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the scarecrow, searching for a brain. I settled on the suture, and for the wisdom that I gain. Unlike the lion, I'd courage to be true, and follow the lotus sutra that teaches that God is inside of you. Those who say there's no heaven in God, they're no more than a wizard of Oz. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself hard. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a heart. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the scarecrow, searching for a brain. I settle on the sutra, and for the wisdom that I gain. I'm not like Dorothy, who's trying to get back home. I practice the Lotus Sutra, doctrine alone. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a heart. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a heart. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the scarecrow, searching for a brain. I settle on the sutra, and for the wisdom that I gain. I'm not like Dorothy, who's trying to get back home. The only thing for the tin man I got, he talked me high to the robot. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a heart. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a heart. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the tin man, skipping on down to Oz, trying to find the yellow brick road, trying to find himself a God. I'm not like the scarecrow, searching for a brain. I settle on the sutra, and for the wisdom that I gain. I'm not like Dorothy, who's trying to get back home. I practice the Lotus Sutra, doctrine alone. Question the greatest.